Welcome to my channel Fee Concepts CHM. This video is about crystal structure. This is the fifth part of the series of crystal physics. Now we will see about the hexagonal closed pack structure, in short called as HCP structure. Here every atom touches six atoms in its own plane, which can be seen from this diagram also, that one atom is touching six atoms in its own plane. Then three atoms below its plane, these atoms are located inside the body of the structure. Same way, if you consider a hexagonal unit cell above this unit cell, it will also have three atoms inside its body. So this atom will be touching those three body atoms. So the coordination number is equal to 12. Each atom at the corner is being shared by six unit cells, which can be seen from this diagram, that if you make unit cells beside one unit cell, you can see that there are three unit cells. This atom is being shared by three unit cells. Same way, you can consider unit cells above these three unit cells. So this atom is being shared by total six unit cells. Also, the atom at the center of the face is shared by two unit cells, that is this unit cell, as well as if you consider unit cell above this unit cell. So this atom at the center is being shared by two unit cells. And there are three body atoms within the crystal. Hence, the total number of atoms in the cell, which we denote as small n, is given by one atom shared by six unit cells into six corners. There are six corners. So this atom is shared by six unit cells. Sorry, this atom, this corner atom is being shared by six unit cells, which we had seen in this diagram. This is about the top face. Top face. Same way, for the bottom face also, we can say that one corner atom is being shared by six unit cells. So 1 by 6, 1/6 part is being contributed by this atom to this unit cell, and that way there are 6 corners, so into 6. So this is for the top face and this is for the bottom face, plus 3 body atoms, and this is about the face centered atom. One face centered atom is being shared by two unit cells, so it is contributing only half part to one unit cell. So half part, and that way there are two faces, top face and bottom face, so into two. This comes as 6. So total number of atoms in the cell is 6. Also, these corner atoms, they touch each other. These corner atoms, they are touching each other. So, the nearest neighboring distance is 2R is equal to A, side of this cell, one side of this cell is equal to A. The lattice constant hence can be given as A is equal to 2R. Now we will calculate the C by A ratio. C is the height of the unit cell. A is its edge, that is one side length. Three body atoms lie in a horizontal plane at the height of C by 2. So the body atoms are lying at the height of C by 2. From the orthocenters of the alternate equilateral triangles on the top or on the base. Orthocenter is shown in this way, the perpendiculars put from the corner to the opposite side. So all these perpendiculars intersect at one point and that point is called as an orthocenter. So the three body atoms lie in a horizontal plane at the height of C by 2 from the orthocenters of alternate equilateral triangles. This they lie at the orthocenters of alternate equilateral triangles this way. So we will consider this part AOB. AOB is shown here in this diagram. And the atom is lying at A, B, O, and one atom is located at a height of C by 2 from the ortho center, that is indicated by Z. This length is A, as these atoms are touching each other. Also, these atoms touch either each other, hence this length is also A. These two atoms also touch each other, hence this side is also A. So we will consider the triangle ABY, which is a right angle triangle, and we will find cos 30 degrees. Cos 30 degree is the adjacent side AY divided by the hypotenuse AB. So AY upon AB is equal to AY upon AB is A. So rearrange the equation to get AY, A into cos 30 degrees. So that is cos 30 is degrees root 3 by 2. So A into root 3 by 2. Now we will consider the triangle AZX, which is a right angle triangle. Apply the Pythagoras theorem. You get AZ square is equal to AX square plus ZX square. This equation we will consider as equation A. Now the orthocenter lies at a height length of 2/3 of AY. So AX is equal to 2/3 of this AY. AY we have found, that is A root 3 by 2, you can substitute here, and that is A upon root 3. So we have got AX. Substituting everything in equation A, this is equation A, you get AZ is A, AX we have just found A by root 3, and ZX is C by 2. So rearranging the equation, you get C square by 4 is equal to 2A square upon 3. Rearrange this equation again, that is C square upon A square, as we have to find the ratio of C by A is equal to 2 into 4 upon 3. Solving this, you get C by A is equal to square root of 8 by 3. Now we will find the volume of the unit cell. For the volume of the unit cell, we will have to find it in this way. The volume of the hexagonal cell is given by area of the base into the height of the cell. So first we will find the area of the base. In the base, there are 6 equilateral triangles. So we'll consider triangle AOB, and this way there are 6 equilateral triangles. So the area of this base is 6 into area of triangle AOB. So triangle AOB, area of the triangle AOB is given by half into OB into AY. Half into OB is A, and AY we have found A root 3 by 2. So now substitute this in this area of base. Area of base is this. Solving this, you get 3 root 3 A square by 2. So now we will find the volume of the unit cell. Area of base is 3 root 3 A square by 2, and height of the cell is C. So this comes as 3 root 3 A square C by 2. Now we will find the volume of all the atoms in the cell. There are 6 atoms in the HCP structure. So 6 into the volume of one atom is 4 by 3 pi r cube. You can substitute r as a by 2. Solving this, you get pi a cube. This is small v. So we'll find the atomic packing factor, which is small v, the volume of all the atoms in the cell, divided by the volume of the hexagonal cell, capital V. Substituting everything, you get 2 pi, pi 3 root 3 into A by C. So now we can substitute the C by A that which we had calculated earlier, that is square root of 8 by 3. So that is square root of 3 by 8. You get 2 pi upon 3 root of 8. Solving this, you get 0.74, that is 74%. So this value is the same as that we had got in the FCC structure. So the atomic packing factor for FCC and the HCP structure is 74%. So these structures are considered to be closed packing structures. Thank you for watching my video.